Packers and those who hit Brussels.
Where did it come from? It's
Well, we left drama school. We were all in the same class. And none of us were working at the time. And we thought, well, do you know what? Let's do a cabaret. And, you know, the Battersea Barge.
I don't think that goes anymore.
No, I don't know.
Actually, thinking about it.
It's a shame. But yeah, so we did a gig there and we thought, oh, well, let's call it Four Friends in Thames. It was a wonderful thing. And then people were like, oh, that was actually really good. So we thought, well, let's go from there. Let's do another one.
Would you have called it Four Friends on the Thames?
Probably not.
No, it's interesting, isn't it? Because you said you created, you got the gig and you created the name around the first gig. So what would you say, having done all the material that you've done now, because you've had some, you know, great, you've got some great numbers to WC, do you think, would there be another name for you?
I don't think there can be now, because we're so used to it. And we've all got our femme names, which is like the Spice Girls had. Yeah, we like the Spice Girls.
Yeah. You could kind of, if you're in different places, you could always, like, I don't know, if you were doing a gig in Dubai, it could be Four Femmes on the Dubai.
You don't know everybody.
It's a desert, isn't it? How about if you went to Egypt? Four Femmes on the Nile.
Oh, exactly. Well,
we went to Paris, Four Femmes on the Seine. Another famous river.
If you go where I'm from, up north, you could go Four Femmes on the Tees.
Ooh, that's good.
Four Femmes on the Tees.
That's
like
better.
That. Oh, actually, that's not
that's
bad.
That's really good.
Where would you like to see the Femmes? Which river would you like to get? Let us know. Facebook.com/Curtain Up Show. Tweet us at Curtain Up Show. Or if you're on Facebook Live, post a message. We need to know where to send the Femmes.
Katie Babe, I'm going to give you an idea now. You should actually write a song with all the river titles.
Yes.
With Four Femmes on the Tees. And I'll take 25%. Thanks very much for that.
And there's an ooze.
And there's oohs.
There's
a
river.
I can see your brain. I know. It's a seven.
I've just written it.
Four Femmes on the ooze.
That's basically our band, that kind of title.
So there's four of you. Who are the other girls in the group?
So we've got, should I give their femme names or
their
names?
Well, give both, really.
I'll give both. So we've got Femme Free Spirit, who is Emma Drysdale. We have Femme Fanciful, the cutesy one that loves love. And that, well, she's actually, I wanted to call her Femme Thick, but, you know, she went up for that. And that's Grace Rowe. She's probably listening, gonna kill me. And then we have Femme Frivolous, who is Abby Mordew, the materialistic one, let's say, likes money.
And those names, are they traits of your individual personalities?
Yeah.
Subconsciously?
They were kind of, my character's the drunk one, which people who know me, I don't drink, so it's
you don't,
ironic
I've never
title.
Been in a bar with you before.
No, exactly. So, it's just a heightened personality thing that we thought we'd play on. And then we've got the Homs, which is our band, our boys, and of course Gavin, who is Honky Tonk, the pianist. He writes the music to my bad lyrics.
And do you all write the songs, or is the one of you that takes more lead in writing?
I tend to take the lead in the writing, but there's been a lot of input between all of us, so.
And so when you come to sort of, because it's all original, it's all your original work, which is really exciting, where do you get the ideas from, apart from going on a radio show where the presenters only strike something about different rivers? Where do your ideas come from?
From, I don't know, really. So, our song Woman Up, which I can't really, we definitely can't play that one.
No, we can't.
But it came from a place where I was watching The Apprentice, and there were a lot of men talking about, taking the exact same format of those phrases and putting it in ours, so Woman Up became.
And did you put this on the old YouTube?
Yeah.
And how many hits have you had?
We're nearly up to 30,000.
That's amazing, isn't it? And so, because I'm fascinated by social media and all that malarkey. So when you put it up, how did you just like share it to friends and then they just?
No, what happened is we decided, because we'd done the Shard video, but we didn't do much publicity towards it, or as much as we should have done, really. So we thought, let's do a launch party for Woman Up. We invited everyone to Century Club, and it was all free for them, and basically got everyone to tweet and Facebook and comment and all that. So it really hit off. In the first week, we were up to about 12,000, 14,000.
Talking of social media, people have just joined the conversation, just tuned in. They're asking what we're exactly what we're talking about. We're talking about Four Guns on the Thames. It's not a stage show. It's a girl group, but it could be a stage show. You've been nominated. You're finalists in the Musical Comedy Awards, which takes place at the Udderbelly on Saturday.
Tomorrow.
So, what's that all about?